Hello class 2, welcome to your value education class. Today we will start with a new chapter, children, and the name of the chapter is Good Habits, isn't it? So it is very important for all of us to cultivate some good habits. So this is the book, as you all know, Inspirations for Life. And today we'll start, as I have already told, we'll start a new chapter, and the name of the chapter is Good Habits. See, and this is the page number 41, and you open your book at page number 41. Okay, I think you all are ready, and as you all know, carry a pencil in your hand. If you do not understand any word, if you find any difficult word or a new word, you can underline and afterward you can ask me. Okay, or otherwise you can see the check in the dictionary also. Fine. So let us start the chapter Good Habits. And what is the value of learning this chapter? It is healthy living. How to live healthy? As you all know that health is wealth, isn't it? So it is our foremost duty to take care of our health. So let's begin. I hope you all are ready. I'll read it loudly. You will also read along me, okay? We say health is wealth. For enjoying life, good health is must. So as to be healthy, you need healthy food. From where do you get this food? Your answer would be, my papa brings food from the market and mom cooks it. Yes, but do you know that there are several other people who help you to get this? Let us see how. Okay, let me explain up to this. So as we all know that health is wealth, isn't it? So we must take care of our health. So for enjoying life, if you want to enjoy your life, you have to maintain a good health, isn't it? So for enjoying life, we must have a good health. To live healthy, you need to have healthy food also. If you want to live healthy, then you have to intake healthy food. Now the question comes, from where do we get this food? As you are quite a little children, so you will say that my papa brings it from the market, isn't it? And my mom cooks it, so we get food. But it is not only your father or your mother who helps you to have the healthy food. There are many people who work hard behind the curtain. Okay, there are so many people who help you to get this food. So in this chapter, we'll come to know who are the people and how do they help us to get the food. Because food is our basic need, isn't it? Without food, can we survive? No, we cannot survive without food, and we should intake enough food, as food gives us energy, isn't it? So, and without food, we will become unwell. So, we have to take healthy food to keep our health proper. Okay, so let us see how. Who are the people and how do they help us to get the food? First, number one is, first the farmer sows the seed or in his farm. Now we need to sow the seed, isn't it? So first of all, suppose we eat rice. Now the farmer, they need to sow the seed, the grain. Then it will turn into a little plant. It will grow into a, the seed will grow, the grain will grow into a plant, isn't it? So first of all, we have to plant it. We have to sow the seed in the farm, okay, in the field. Then he means the farmer here. He and his family take care of the crop until it is ready to harvest. Then the farmer and his family, they used to take care of the crop until it is ready for harvest. What is the meaning of harvest? Harvest means collecting the ripe crops. Okay, so after it grows into a crop, food crop, then we reap it, means cut it. Okay, cut the crop, we reap the crop. After reaping, we do harvesting, means we collect the ripe crop. So the farmer and his family, they take care of the plant until it is ready for harvest. Then number three, then it is harvested, then it is collected and then sent to the nearest wholesale market. Then it is sent to the wholesale market for selling purpose. Okay, now the greengrocer, number four, the greengrocers and the vendors buy the fruits and vegetables and then sell them. And from the wholesale market, the greengrocer and the vendors, means greengrocers and the vendors, they are the person who sells the fruits and vegetables and the crops. Okay, so the greengrocers and the vendors, they buy the fruits and vegetables from the wholesale market and then sell them. Okay, then what happens? Your father buys them and your mother cooks them for you. This is how we get the food that we eat. Okay, now finally you eat the healthy and delicious food at home. And finally we get the healthy and the delicious food at home. What is the meaning of delicious? Delicious means tasty. Okay, in order to keep yourself fit and healthy, in order to keep ourselves strong, fit and healthy, you have to remember some important thing. How to keep ourselves healthy? We have to follow some instructions. We have to follow some good habits. Okay, we should follow some good habits if we want to keep ourselves fit and strong. And what are they? Let us learn in this chapter. Turn the page to page number 42. Okay, turn the page, we'll come to page number 42 now. 4 to 42. So these are some of the good habits that we have to follow if we want to keep ourselves fit and strong. Okay, now first of all, wash your hands before eating thing. Okay, as you all know that before we eat food or we take our meal, we should wash our hands, isn't it? Then number two, always eat clean food. We have to intake the clean food. And number three, wash the fruits before eating. It is very important for us to get to have fruits every day. But whenever you will take a fruit, you will have a fruit, you have to clean and wash it properly. Clear? Never keep the food uncovered. We should not keep the food uncovered. These are some good habits. Okay. Now number five is, do not eat anything that has been cut and left uncovered for a long time. We should not eat those fruits or vegetables that are kept, that have been cut but kept uncovered for a long period of time. Okay. Number six, never buy rotten food. We should not buy rotten food. Rotten food means the food, those are not fresh. Okay. Then number seven, always drink pure, clean and filtered water. So you should not drink impure water. Okay. So you need to drink pure, clean and filtered water if you want to keep yourself healthy and strong. Isn't it? Now while eating, now these are the things we should keep in mind. We should follow, these are some of the good habits that we should follow every day in our life. Okay. Now, while eating, you should maintain some good table manners. Now, table manners means what? When we are eating together, means we eat in our family, we eat together, means myself, suppose yourself, your father, your mother, your grandparents, your siblings, you all sit together and eat, isn't it? In the dining table. So whenever you are eating, you should follow some etiquettes, some manners. Okay, these are known as table manners. Okay, now while we are eating, we should maintain some good table manners. What are those? So we will read here. Okay, point wise. Number one, as you all know that, wash your hand before and after every meal. So before and after every meal, we should wash our hand, as you all do, I hope and I believe. So number two is, place a napkin on your lap. We should always place a napkin on your lap. Why? Why to place a napkin on your lap? So that the food doesn't drop onto your clothes, isn't it? Otherwise, your clothes will get dirty. So always put a napkin on your lap. Number three, when you need to ask for something, suppose you need something, okay, then how to behave? What you have to say is, please pass me the bowl or the plate. Suppose if you need some salt, you can say, please pass me the salt. Okay, please pass me the glass of water. This way you have to request. Okay, now number four, chew the food properly. When you are sitting and having meal together, you have to chew the food properly. This means what? Means you should not chew the food noisily. Okay, it is a bad manner, right? So you should chew the food properly without making any noise. Okay, then you have to avoid talking while eating. You should not talk whenever you are eating. You should not talk. It is a bad manner. Now number six, avoid making noise while using cutlery. When you are using the fork and the spoon while eating, you should not make any kind of noise. Okay, so you should avoid making noise when you are using the cutlery. Then don't waste food. We should not waste food. It is very important. Number eight, if others are still eating and you have finished your own, then take their permission before leaving the table. Suppose you have finished your part, okay, you have eaten, now you want to move out, so you want to wash your hand. So what you will do, you need to take permission from those who are still having their lunch or dinner or having their meal. Okay, you should take the permission. How you will take the permission? You should say, excuse me, and then you leave the table. So these are the table manners you should follow when you are eating together in a family. Maybe outside, if you go to your friend's place, then okay. So these are the things that you should follow. Clear? Now after eating your meal, don't forget to thank God. Okay, the foremost important is, God is our creator. Whatever we are getting, it is the gift of God. So after eating and before eating also, we should pray to God, isn't it? So most of you, I think you pray to God before eating, isn't it? So after eating your meal, don't forget to thank God for the healthy meal. Clear? Now we will read one story, that is Rima's Promise. So we'll do it in the next class. Okay, till then you go through all the good habits that you should follow and the table manners that you are supposed to maintain when you are having your meal. So go through this thing, and afterward in the next class we will read out the story Rima's Promise. Okay, thank you.